Hi, I wanted to do a video or talk a little bit about practicing without your instruments. I call it mental musical calisthenics. There's a lot that can be gained by visualizing your playing, and in and of itself, practicing without the instrument is really, really great mental calisthenics for, becoming a better musician. So one of the things I like to do is visualize the fretboard. So there are a couple of exercises that I do when I don't have my instrument. One is trying to visualize the fretboard in different ways. The first is chromaticizing it. So for example, I want to know that I know the fretboard inside and out or as best as possible. So one of the first exercises I like to do is basically think about the notes and how they lay out on the fretboard itself. So for example, I will think of the low E string and I'll say, okay, so I'll typically will close my eyes and say, okay, low E string, open E, boom. First fret is F. Then the second fret on the low E string is F sharp. The third fret is G. The fourth fret is G sharp, A flat. The fifth fret is A. And then the sixth fret is A sharp, B flat, and so on and so forth. So that's the low E. Then I'll go and I'll think about the A string. It's adjacent to the low E. Open A. The next fret, which would be first fret, would be A sharp B flat. Then the second fret would be B. Then the third fret would be C. The fourth fret C sharp D flat. The fifth fret would be a D. Okay, so that's one way. So trying to think about it as mental calisthenics and practicing that way, memorizing the fretboard. So I do that occasionally. And then a couple of times I'll just play games, mental games with myself and say, okay, fifth fret, A string, that's a D. Fifth fret on the B string, that's an E. Things like that. So first practicing it chromatically in your head, memorizing the notes, and then skipping around. Okay, so another thing I like to do is think about intervals, fourths next to each other. So on one string next to each other. So for example, I'll think about the E string and the A string and say the fourths would be on the third fret. That would be a G and a C. The fourths on the fifth fret would be an A and a D. And I'm doing this as I'm doing this video. So things like that. So memorizing fourths. Then you can go up and think about it in terms of thirds. One, three. So think about it in terms of thirds. Okay, thirds on the E and the A string. So let's just say I'm on the G note, which is the third fret. A third from that would be a B. Okay, let's say I'm on the C. A third on that, if I'm on the C, which would be like an A, and the D string, I'm thinking of E. So a third, so a C and E, and so on and so forth. So this gets me thinking about the fretboard. And let me tell you this, that if I've missed a lot of stops on trains just thinking about the guitar that way. So that'll help you visualize that. So that's one way. Another thing you can do other than just the notes itself is you can mentally practice scales. So if I'm thinking about a G major scale, like say in first position, I can think of it that I'm not going to use any open notes. So I'm on the low E string, that's a G. Then I'm going to hit the fifth fret, that's an A. Then I'm going to hit the A string now. And I'm gonna be on a B note, which is gonna be on the second fret of the A string. Then I'm gonna be on a C note. Then I'm gonna be on a D. Then I'm gonna be on an E, which now puts me at the D string. So that would be an E, and that would be the second fret of the D string. Then the F is gonna be sharp. I know that, so that's gonna be on the fourth fret of the D string. And then I'm going to resolve it back to the tonic, which is going to be G, which is going to be that would be the sixth fret. Actually, that would be the fifth fret. Apologize. So, but you get the idea. So that's one way of thinking about it. So you think about it chromatically. You think about it in intervals. You can start with thirds. You can do fourths. Then you think about it scale-wise. Then I start visualizing even chords. It could start off with the open position chords. Everybody knows what a C is. So boom, I'm thinking about a C. I'm thinking about a chord progression. C, A minor, D, G. First position. C, boom, A minor, boom, D, boom, and then G, boom, this way. So again, it's hard to talk about it because you're visualizing it, but you get the idea. So focus on that, work it out, and it's a fun way to learn the fretboard without your instruments. And you'll find out that the minute you go back to your instrument after you've done a couple of exercises like that, it's going to be a lot easier for you to navigate the fretboard. All right? Thank you.